Yat eh, welcome to Four Directions of Wellness. I'm Roberta Diswit, Twopa Hanishla, Sisakani Bashishin, Nankaidina Dishache, Hanahni Dishanella. With us today is Tatna Banat Ani and Roy Cady with the Nepi Inna, the Navajo Lifeway. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
Chaya Tatna Banat Ani and Shiga. Do Hawathan and Shle, Ado, Maidish Kishni A Bashishin, Nankaidina Dishache, Do Tsena Bishni Dishanella.
Well, thank you guys both for being here. Go ahead and tell me, what is the Nepi Inna?
The Nepi Inna is a non-profit organization, and it was established on the Navajo Nation many years ago. And I can have my colleague Roy elaborate on that.
The Nepi Inna. Oli yehegi shi jo bilaganik eche e yaha e Navajo Lifeway bidina. Benache e yaha e bijik hazli igi shi jo nihe e naat e de be e adon naltlon shi dadan lenigi e e bits ado e yaha e e na ilt e ande na rede nat ad e shi e hashin tsogo e yaha e nihe hazli do hoshne nit nhani liado e nihe in na ko e bansi kes e ben na che ya e hot a e the organization jo be ni ni blakane ke che hot a bje hazle a do e yisi ben na shi yo sinigi e di na n ka do the be do is a do a shi na l plan shi n le ni jo e ba kha ya do n ta na l ka ko ta a kha de a do research el on scientifically ko ta jo hot a ya ha e di de ne be in na ge e kwa e ka na lo na re nat a e ha de shi e ya ha e shi sa ni de ku shi e l shi hot a el hi kre shi o hot a ba da ha je le a do shi kwa shi ya ni da s ti a do shi e ya ha e be le shi da ho lo da ne le 1991 ya da a ni de ya na shi hot in a hot a shi e e e ya shin e kha shin ta shin yan ge das ti a do shin ho do ne jo ta ne he it on do an he e ya e kha de it a de e it on shin e e din hin an ne shi de ne hli ni zi a pe a do kha la an na ge je tsa ga ho zan je ni he ni he na at an i dan le ni gi e do yon kha ya nat e da da no shi hin na chi shin ho ta shin ta hil tsod e adoshi e bayanas tit on the tashi na his na hit nel tineshi beojo e ade hal wodigi da ado ablakanik echo e ya e navo whole life way but ninigi it's an organization don ko do ya in hit hol na non profit is long ado on the ta ni mission linigi or main mission in for the nebeina is again for scientific research, and also to support the fiber and also livestock owners, to give them the opportunity and not just to have a voice, but also to give them the tools necessary to keep and to further on their involvement and also their expertise, their, you know, and that's what we provide with the Nepi Inna, and it's open to anyone, basically, and anybody who feels and wishes to be part of the organization is welcome. So, and I just want to mention the organization, the base of the organization, it states in our missions, and it's a goal that we always review is it's the people, it's the people's organization, and it's the people meaning the Navajo people. Who founded this organization. So they are the ones that pursue and to continue to pursuit of what is ahead in the future.
And so back when they started it, you know, you mentioned it was for, you know, there was parts of, you know, at Window Rock and, you know, not getting that support for the people who were, you know, doing fiber arts. How did you guys, you know, how did you find all those people, you know, that were able to get this organization together?
I'd like to mention an individual who I feel had a great, not just an input, but also I think she was, we always refer to her sometimes as one of the founding mothers, and that's Dr. Annie Winika. And she advocated on our behalf. You know, she was one of the first Navajo women councilwomen to be part of the Navajo Nation government. And she's consistently, in her term, had advocated on our behalf, but not everybody, you know, saw that venture. And she's also the one who we consider, and in fact, we have an award that's given in her honor, and it's a Shepherdess Award. And it's a lifetime achievement for, you know, our elders who have you know, has pursued in being a shepherdess. You know, there's a lot of support that at the time, you know, that was a part of the influence of getting this grassroots organization started. But just to mention one, it would be her. And you know, everything starts small. And so it grew, and then the word got out. This all happened somewhere in Ganado, and that's where it originated from. And from there, it grew, you know, people in the community, and then it, today, it's here in our backyard in Shiprock. So with that kind of idea, meaning it's an organization that, you know, takes ground wherever it's at, and it's the community who rouse up the support to keep it in a community, to drain it from any and every aspect that they can, you know, whether it be a grant that they want to work with. Earlier she talked about, you know, teaching our own fiber artists about marketing strategies, things like that. You know, they're well-to-do instructions and learning. A lot of hands-on learning is provided. But, you know, those are just some of the things just to initially mention that the organization does in that.
You know,
I hope I answered.
That
I kind of went, you know, floating
but it,
away.
But it really is good for people to know that, you know, this is something that started from, you know, a group of weavers, a group of, you know, shepherds who wanted something more that brought them together and be able to do, you know.
Right. Yeah, I think that also when the organization was formed in the early 90s in the community of Ganado, by the local sheep herders and weavers. There was, at that time, the support to continue on with the pastoral way of life was minimal in the council. And Dr. Winika, Annie Winika, advocated on behalf of the continuance, the support of the Navajo Chiro, along with Dr. McNeil. So the pastoral way of life in the sheep herding subjects, in the Navajo weaving subjects, in the range management subjects, they were all being practiced in all the communities all over Navajo land, but quietly and not with the full support of the council. So when this grassroots organization started, soon the communities begin to recognize our people, our pastoral people, which we can accredit today for the Navajo people's existence. If it wasn't for our grandmothers and our grandfathers who hung on to the ways of herding sheep and feeding the family and making a weaving to keep the children warm or to sell at the store for food. If it wasn't for the pastoral way of life, we wouldn't, you know, I don't know where we would be as Navajo people. So when we think of the Navajo Lifeway organization, it's a organization that we're trying to continue with its sustainability. Mm-hmm. And with the modern times now, we're interweaving education, Western education, mm-hmm. with the traditional education. We're finding a balance with that. Mm-hmm. And with that, a new wave of enthusiasm is happening. There's communities across Navajo land that are thirsting to learn about sheep herding, that are just have a desire to spin wool or to collect plants. And with this organization, we're able to educate some of those communities. Mm-hmm. But we still need support from the council, mm-hmm. and we still need support from the community. And as my brother Roy was saying, the organization is a community's organization. It belongs to the Navajo people. And when the people ask Dine Be'ina, perhaps about a certain Navajo weaving design, the revival of it, it is the Dine Be'ina's responsibility, because it belongs to the people, mm-hmm. to find the instructors, to find the presenters, to teach the community, mm-hmm. that skill. So, and it's a communal involvement, which is common for our people. Our people, we all work together as a community long ago, and with the Dine Be'ina, we're practicing that.
If you are just joining us, you're watching Four Directions of Wellness, and I'm Roberta Diswood. We are talking with Kutna Bonnet Ani and Roy Cady from the Dine Be'ina. So you guys talked about the organization, and you touched a little bit on some of the activities and events that you guys host. Could you talk more about those?
The Dine Be'ina organization hosts the annual Sheep is Life celebration. And this year, in 2012, it's going to be the 16th annual. And it's going to be held in Salley, Arizona, at the Dine College. And at the Sheep is Life celebration, we're starting out with pre-celebration workshops. And this is open to anyone who wishes to learn how to weave the Navajo way, mm-hmm. Maybe learn sash belt weaving, maybe also some felting, mm-hmm. Different types of felting of hats, maybe bags. Mm-hmm. And these pre-celebration workshops are the paid workshops. Mm-hmm. And then on Friday and Saturday are the workshops that are open to the public. And these are the demonstration workshops and some of the seminars. Mm-hmm. And that is free to the public.
Okay. And so the Sheep is Life is one. And I know I've heard about some stuff like the spinoffs. What are spinoffs?
Do you want to elaborate?
We can, yeah. Spinoffs are, again, it's a community support, sort of a fiber artist and fiber enthusiast, people who are interested in learning about fiber techniques. And, you know, we sometimes cover, you know, sheep herding because we have them in the audience. So we capture them at the moment and say, hey, you know, how do you herd your sheep? You know, what do you do about, you know, medicinal care or You know, are there holistic medicinal plants that you know that I don't know? Mm-hmm. You know, that sort of thing takes place. It's a very relaxed atmosphere. And really, I think the two of us here, we're the founders of the spin-offs. And it's something that we gathered the stories from our parents and our grandparents who used to say, well, you know, in the winter months, we used to always, you know, go to our neighbors, you know, and then somehow word got around and, you know, and somebody hosted an evening of carding wool and spinning to make time go by faster. And, you know, the host would provide the main dish and then the rest of us, we would bring what we could, mm-hmm. you know. And from there, you know, the idea came. The idea was born to reintroduce that in our communities. And now it's grown. We try to encourage other communities by identifying someone who could start as a host or a hostess. Mm-hmm. And then we give them the tools. We come to their spinoff and say, okay, this is what a spinoff is. And, you know, it's structured to your own liking, mm-hmm. you know, what you want to learn. What more emphasis do you want on learning about sheep herding or, you know, whatever. But it's really to also give that sense of communal again, mm-hmm. because somehow we've shied away from being a community unit. And so spin-offs are a great way to get your communities back into a community, mm-hmm. A loving community, and a community who can start to, you know, have wonderful change in their community in terms of the support that they used to provide with one another. Mm-hmm. And so, yeah, spin-offs are really wonderful and cool functions. And we're now